Mother baboon gave birth to her baby barely a week ago. It only weighs a few hundred grams. After a six-month gestation, it started life with big ears and a black coat. From the very beginning, this little fellow was the center of attention. Baboons love babies. It's in their nature. In the very first days of their life, these little monkeys can't walk. They still have trouble coordinating the use of their rather long limbs. Never mind. They'll very soon be striding across the savannah. When their mother puts them under her belly, their instinct tells them to get a firm grip on her coat. They use five anchor points, the two hands and two feet, but also their mouth clamped onto the teat. This system is highly efficient. The mother minds her child. She carries it and suckles it, while at the same time looking for food. The mother is in no way hampered in her movements. And as the baby hangs on so well, she can even gallop with no problem. The young baboons that form a unit with their mothers already go everywhere with the herd. It's an early and unconscious initiation into the life that lies ahead of them. Lesson number one. A spider's nest is a good source of protein. In their second month, young baboons begin to master their motor skills. They can unhook from their mother and explore their surroundings. Mum is never far away. Just as a reminder that she's still in charge, but also to ensure that her offspring is protected and fed. Baboons love to handle the babies of other baboons. That's what seems to be interesting this female. But she doesn't insist, because she knows that mothers don't lend out their young before they're 2 months old. At this age, they have to suckle frequently. The mother's milk is still their only food. They'll be weaned gradually, after about a year. But it's not unusual to see larger offspring compete with a younger sibling over the mother's breast. Baboons grow up in a complex, very hierarchical society. At about 3 months, when they start to play or fight with others, they learn their place in the group. The largest one here is at least 6 months old, as we can tell from its oatmeal color. Baboons' coats start to lighten when they're 3 months old. They still hang on to their mother, but they've changed position. This one must be more comfortable than hanging onto the mother's belly. But there is one drawback. You simply can't be carried around and suckle at the same time. This little monkey isn't even thinking about it. He's asleep, recuperating after the long walk he's just had. He's only 4 months old, and he's beginning to follow the herd around on the ground. In other words, he walks for about 6 hours a day. There's one challenge the baby has to face: to keep up the pace and not get left behind. The group walks quite briskly, and he must on no account lose touch with the others. If they get cut off from the rest of the herd, young baboons are highly exposed to any number of predators. At this age, they have less to fear from the leopard, their favorite enemy, than from raptors, jackals, or snakes. These animals appear very vulnerable in open spaces. However, their predation rate is quite low. And yet, the mothers are not particularly attentive to their young. As for the dominant males, they take their part in keeping the group safe, but no more than the others do. Young baboons manage to survive reasonably well because they rely on everyone being vigilant. When the babies get too tired, or sometimes just for fun, they sit astride the mother with a jockey-like technique that is all their own. By the time their coat is all beige and the muzzle all black, the baboons are already big children. By their first birthday, they're completely autonomous, able to feed themselves and survive, if necessary, the death of their mother. They spend a lot of time eating and put on 500 grams every 3 months. When they reach adulthood, males will weigh about 30 kilos and the females half that much. These young baboons that have learned everything in the few months in early childhood are now going to take their time moving into full adulthood. The females will have their first offspring at about 6 years old. As for the males, they will have to wait another 2 or 3 years to be able to pass on their genes. Meanwhile, these youngsters in the middle of the group form a happy bunch, always ready for some fun. Well away from this excitement, the savannah has welcomed a new inhabitant: a baby giraffe. As newborns go, it's one of the biggest imaginable. At birth, it was already nearly 2 meters tall. The calf made a dramatic entrance into the world. As giraffes give birth standing up, the baby drops almost 2 meters to the ground. It was standing within 15 minutes and suckling after an hour. Giraffe's milk is very nutritious, and this allows nursing times to be spaced out. By the time it's 2 weeks old, the young giraffe is drinking only once every 3 hours.